Now it begins. Yes, it's gonna start all over on needles and pins. I'm so out of pride about her. She makes every day a mystery, a true adventure. I should just walk away, but I know that I can live without her. There she goes, messing with my mind again. Oh no, there she goes, messing with my mind again. Sometimes she does, and then sometimes she don't. Sometimes she will, and then sometimes she won't. Messing with my mind again.
Welcome to Thematic Nostalgia. This is show number 65, and I am your host. My name is Phil. I'm going to start right off with a buried treasure. It's a song that you never heard before, in all likelihood. In fact, neither did I. But my son heard it. He asked me if I ever heard of a singer called Sanford Clark. And I told him I did, but I only knew of one song that he did called The Fool. In checking, I discovered he actually had two charting hits on the pop chart, but The Fool was his only charting hit on the country chart. Brooke Palmer recently played The Fool on a recent edition of the Antique Music Mall, if you'd like to hear that. Now, this first song we're going to play is by Sanford Clark, and it's called It's Nothing to Me. It's a country music song, and you know, country music sometimes has a lot of dark songs, and nobody wrote darker songs than somebody named Leon Payne, who is also known as Pat Patterson. He was a blind songwriter who wrote the weird classic called Psycho in 1968. And that was sung by Eddie Nowak. So now I'm going to go on to the song we're going to play first of all. It's called, like I said, It's Nothing to Me. And I think you're going to recognize the theme of this program after a few songs. But in case you don't, we will reveal that theme after the fifth song. So let's hear Sanford Clark.
Take your drink to the end of the bar, buddy, let her stay there. Now don't be a fool. I'd as soon have a hot seat in Sing Sing prison than to sit down by her on that stool. What's that you say? I guess you're right. It's nothing to me. See that man, she belongs to him. Buddy, better drink up and go while you can. I can tell by the way he looks at you, buddy, that he's sure a quick-tempered, jealous man. What's that you say? I guess you're right. It's nothing to me. There you are, stretched out on the floor, buddy, now you see what you made him do. Here they come to take him off to jail, buddy, and tomorrow someone will bury you. Oh well, that's life. Or it was. It nothing to me.
Originally entitled Frankie and Albert, this traditional ballad was inspired by a real-life crime committed by Frankie Baker in 1899. Frankie would be acquitted of this crime by reason of self-defense. And in 1908, the Layton brothers wrote this song and published it a few years later in 1912. And it brought us that familiar opening, Frankie and Johnny were lovers. They had a quarrel one day. Now, in 1927, it was the first year that this song made it to the pop chart, and there were two versions of it. They both came out approximately the same time. But I'm going to play the version by Frank Crummett, an extremely popular 1920s musical, Broadway musical entertainer, and he also had a radio show with his wife, Julie Sanderson, from 1929 to 1943. So let's listen to Frankie and Johnny by Frank Crummett.
Frankie and Johnny were lovers. Oh Lord, how they did love. Swore to be true to each other, just as true as the stars up above. He was a man. He wouldn't do her wrong. Frankie went down to the corner just for a bucket of beer. She said, Mr. Bartender, has my lovin' Johnny been here? He is my man. He wouldn't do me wrong. I don't want to cause you no trouble. I don't want to tell you no lie. But I saw your lover half an hour ago with a girl named Nellie Bly. He is your man, but he's doing you wrong. Frankie looked over the transom. There, to her great surprise, there on the couch sat Johnny, making love to Nellie Bly. He was her man. He was doing her wrong. Frankie threw back her kimono, took out a little 44. Rudy tutu, three times she shot right through that hardwood door. She shot her man, cause it done her wrong. Roll me over easy, roll me over slow. Roll me over on the left side, cause your bullets hurt me so. I was your man, and I done you wrong. Bring out your rubber-tied horses, bring out your rubber-tied hacks. I'm taking my man to the graveyard, and ain't going to bring him back. He was my man, and he done me wrong. Bring round 1,000 policemen, bring them round today, to lock me in that dungeon cell and throw the key away. I shot my man, cause he'd done me wrong. Frankie, she said to the warden, what are they going to do? The warden, he said to Frankie, it's the electric chair for you. You shot your man, so he'd done you wrong. The sheriff came round in the morning, said it was all for the best. He said her lover, Johnny, was nothing but a doggone pest. He was her man, but he'd done her wrong. This story has no moral, this story has no end. This story only goes to show that there ain't no good in men. He was her man, and he'd done her wrong.
This next song was co-written and performed by Barry Allen Pincus, born in Brooklyn, 1943. But we know him better as Barry Manilow. He studied at New York City's Juilliard School and he worked as the musical director for the WCBS television show Callback. In 1972, he was Bette Midler's accompanist on her nightclub act in a New York City nightclub. But shortly thereafter, he left and he struck out on his own, and he did fairly well. He had 28 top 100 hits. Three of those reached number one. But this will be one of his 11 top 10 hits from 1978, and it's about the Copacabana, a famous nightclub in New York City named after a district in Rio de Janeiro, which is where the song's action takes place. True to the song, this club did become a disco in the 1970s. Most of Barry Manilow's audience had never stepped foot in the Copa, but it was a world-famous nightclub thanks to many celebrity patrons and high-profile entertainers such as Frank Sinatra. It shows up in many movies, most notably including the 1947 film by Groucho Marx and Carmen Miranda, which was called Copacabana. Now, Barry Manilow recalled on the music liner notes he put down for his album called Even Now that the words in the song came incredibly fast. He wrote that, "I remember putting the lyrics on the piano's music stand, punching the record button on my tape deck, and writing the song in less than 15 minutes. Well, seems to have worked as far as I can tell. This is Copacabana by Barry Manilow.
Her name was Lola, she was a showgirl, with yellow feathers in her hair, and a dress cut down her there. She would merengue and do the cha-cha, and while she tried to be a star, Tony always tended bar across the crowded floor. They worked from 8 till 4, they were young and they had each other. Who could ask for more at the Copa, Copa Cabana, the hottest spot north of Havana, at the Copa, Copa Cabana. Music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa. They fell in love.
Copa Cabana.
His name was Rico, he wore a diamond, he was escorted to his chair. He saw Lola dancing there, and when she finished, he called her over. But Rico went a bit too far, Tony sailed across the bar, and then the punches flew, and chairs were smashed in two. There was blood and a single gunshot, but just who shot who at the Copa, Copa Cabana, the hottest spot north of Havana, at the Copa, Copa Cabana. Music and passion were always the fashion at the Copa. She lost her love. Her name is Lola, she was a showgirl, but that was 30 years ago when they used to have a show. Now it's a disco, but not for Lola. Still in the dress she used to wear, faded feathers in her hair, she sits there so refined and drinks herself half blind. She lost her youth and she lost the Tony, now she's lost her mind at the Copa, Copa Cabana, the hottest spot north of Havana.
Here I-
According to Joe Nick Petoskey in his book, An Epic Life, Willie Nelson, Nelson was inspired by his then-wife, Connie Kupka, to write a Western concept album, and she suggested the inclusion of author Guitar Boogie Smith's Tale of the Red-Headed Stranger. And Willie Nelson actually sang that song many times on his radio shows from KCNC in Fort Worth, Texas, as well as singing the song to his children at bedtime. And he included events that were really not even in the original song. He added some more details, and he put out an album which was called Red-Headed Stranger, and he had the title track in that particular album. Now, this was Willie Nelson's first charting pop album from 1975. It ranked at number 28 on the Top 40 Albums chart, and it was a number one country LP in 1975. But as we often do on Thematic Nostalgia, we'll play the original version of The Red-Headed Stranger. And that song was written by Edith Lindemann and Carl Stutz, and that was published in 1953. It was originally written for Perry Como, if you can believe it, but the song was never recorded by him due to publishing issues. Now, I love Perry Como, but I'm glad this song was kept in the country venue, if you will, the country genre. There have been 17 documented versions of this song and over the last 70 years, and there was also one released just a few years ago in 2020 by the Petersons. But you will be listening to the very first release of this song from 1954. It's by Arthur Smith, who had the first nationally syndicated country music show on television. This will be Arthur Smith and the Cracker Jacks. Yes, they still make Cracker Jacks, 127 years old and going strong.
A red-headed stranger from Blue Rock, Montana, rode into town one day. And under his knees was a raging black stallion, and loping behind was a bay. The red-headed stranger had eyes like the thunder, lips that were sad and tight. His little lost love was asleep on the hillside, his heart it was heavy as night.
Don't cross him, don't cross him, he's wild in his sorrow, he's riding and hiding his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow and maybe he'll ride on again.
A yellow-haired woman leaned out of her window, watched as he passed her way. She drew back in fear at the sight of the stallion and cast greedy eyes on the bay. But how could she know that the dancing bay pony meant more to him than life? For that was the horse that his little lost darling had ridden when she was his wife. The yellow-haired woman went down to the tavern, looked up the stranger there. He bought her a drink and he gave her some money, he just didn't seem to care. She followed him out when he sat on the stallion, laughed as she grabbed at the bay. He shot her so quick they had no time to warn her, she never heard anyone say.
Don't cross him, don't cross him, he's wild in his sorrow, he's riding and hiding his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow and maybe he'll ride on again.
The yellow-haired woman was buried at sunset, the stranger went free, of course. For you can't hang a man for killing a woman who's trying to steal his horse. So this is the tale of the red-headed stranger, and if he should come your way, step out of the path of the raging black stallion and don't lay a hand on the bay.
Don't cross him, don't boss him, he's wild in his sorrow, he's riding and hiding his pain. Don't fight him, don't spite him, just wait till tomorrow and maybe he'll ride on again.
This will be the last song we play before we reveal the theme. The most famous version of the song may have been by Jimi Hendrix in 1967, although his version never made the pop chart. it was a Joe Whitburn non-Hot 100 classic song. And a year earlier, in 1966, a psychedelic rock group named Love also had a Joe Whitburn non-Hot 100 song with the same song. Now it's 1966, and folk singer Tim Rose has a breakout hit, and still in 1967, Cher has a top 100 hit with this song. So let's fast forward now two more years to 1969, and Wilson Pickett would have a top 30 R&B hit with this song that did cross over to the pop chart. So as you can see, in the mid to late 1960s, this song was very popular and recorded in various styles. In fact, it's still being recorded. There have been over 435 documented versions of this next song. But we're going to play the highest charting version and the very first version of this song. And it was a one-hit wonder for this group, who were known as a garage rock band, and they were called The Leaves. And this song was first on the Mira label, M-I-R-A, and it was known then as Hey Joe, Where You Gonna Go? It came out again a few months later simply as Hey Joe. So, let's play that song, and it peaked at number 31 in the year of 1966. It hit the chart in May of that year, and it remained on the chart for over 2 months. This group, again, is called The Leaves.
Hey, Joe, where you going with that girl?
If you did not know, all these songs featured someone getting shot and killed. Raise your hand. Well, that's good. I only see two hands out of all those raised arms. In our first song, a quick-tempered, jealous man shot this guy at a bar for paying too much attention to his woman. And now he's stretched out on the floor. Frankie shot her man because he was doing her wrong. And she was also at a bar. Drinking and guns seem to inflame feelings of cupidity. And here we are again at the Copa, a nightclub with drinking. There was blood and a single gunshot. But who shot who? Well, obviously, it was Rico who shot Tony. And then we have some yellow-haired woman being shot to death by some red-headed stranger just for touching his stallion. And guess what? He had just come out of a tavern. She never realized that the red-headed stranger was in serious need of grief counseling. And finally, this guy Joe is going out to find his woman. She's been running around with some other man. I'll shoot them both before I'm through. And then his plan was to run off to Mexico. I probably would have advised Joe, just go find another woman instead. Let's continue with two shootings that do not revolve around bars or jealousy. Next, we have some high school girl shooting her principal. As a former principal myself, I find this solution to resolving anger issues much too drastic. Gone unchecked, we've had to experience far too many school shootings. This will be the Babettes singing I Shot Mr. Lee. This was a top 100 hit in 1960 and followed their top 10 hit from 1957 called Mr. Lee. And that's when all the trouble began with the principal. And that will be followed by Eric Clapton's number one hit from 1974. It's called I Shot the Sheriff. The perpetrator tells us that he shot Sheriff John Brown, but swears it was in self-defense. We don't really know how the story ends, but the shooter went into hiding and predicts that one day the bucket in the well will have its bottom drop out.
With the gun, 6, 7, 8, ha! I'm Mr. Lee had a day. 9, 10, 11, ha! And now he's up in heaven.
Six,
Laredo, Texas, founded in 1755, was then a part of the New Spain Spanish colony in what is now modern-day Mexico. It was only after 1846, during the Mexican-American War, that this area, including Laredo, was ceded to the United States, thanks to the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo. And then there's that song, Streets of Laredo. We played a version of that song on the Antique Music Mall, show number 47, by Eddie Arnold. Streets of Laredo is a cowboy ballad derived from the English folk song, The Unfortunate Lad. It's been known by many other titles. As a folk ballad, Streets of Laredo has been performed by many well-known recording artists over the years, although authorship of the revised version was claimed by Frank H. Maynard in 1924. My sources tell me there are over 700 versions of this song known by different titles, including Cowboy's Lament. It is the story of a cowboy told by a young cowboy about to die due to a fatal gunshot wound to another cowboy who passes by the young man's body in the streets of Laredo. This will be the first known recorded version of this song as Cowboy's Lament. It's from 1927 by Vernon Dalhart. He was a country music singer and a songwriter. During the 1920s and the 1930s, Dalhart used over 100 pseudonyms to record over 5,078 RPM singles. He was inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame in 1981.
As I walked out in the streets of Laredo, as I walked out in Laredo one day, I spied a poor cowboy wrapped up in white linen, as cold as the clay. I see by your outfit that you are a cowboy, these words he did say as I boldly stepped by. Come sit down beside me and hear my sad story. I was shot in the breast and I know I must die. Oh, beat the drum slowly and play the fife slowly and play the dead march as you carry me along. Take me to the green valley and lay the sod o'er me, for I'm a young cowboy and I have done wrong. Let 16 bold gamblers come handle my coffin. Let 16 brave cowboys come sing me a song. Take me out to the graveyard and lay the sod o'er me, for I'm a poor cowboy and I know I done wrong. To my gray-haired mother and carry the same to my sister so dear. But never a word of this note shall you mention when boys gather round you my story to hear. It was once in the saddle I used to go dashing. Oh, once in the saddle I used to ride gay. It was first to the dram house and then to the card house. Got shot in the breast and I'm dying today. Go bring me some water, a cup of cold water, to cool my parched lips, this the cowboy then said. But before I got to him, the spirit had left him and gone to its maker, the cowboy was dead. We beat the drum slowly and played the fife slowly and bitterly wept as we bore him along. For we all loved our comrade so brave and so handsome. We all loved our comrade although he'd done wrong.
Let's go back to back with two would-be gunslingers who may have gotten more than they bargained for. Don't Take Your Guns to Town, from 1958 into 1959, was written and sung by Johnny Cash. Billy Joe, a young cowboy trying to be a man, would have been better served listening to his mother. But then we'd have no song to talk about. This single was Johnny Cash's fifth release to reach number one on the country chart, where it stayed for 6 weeks. The song also crossed over, peaking at number 32 on the pop chart. And then we have another cowboy, Enchanted by Felina, in Rose's Cantina in El Paso. This too was a number one country song, and also a number one pop song. He was able to get away from Felina's man before he could shoot him. But could he stay away from Felina? No. He had to come back, and that was his big mistake. This song won the first Grammy ever awarded in the category of Best Country and Western Performance. Country America magazine ranked El Paso number 6 on their top 100 country songs of all time. Marty Robbins went on to further success, not only as a singer, but also an actor, TV host, NASCAR race driver, and a writer. He penned the novel, The Small Man.
A young cowboy named Billy Joe grew restless on the farm. A boy filled with wanderlust who really meant no harm. He changed his clothes and shined his boots and combed his dark hair down. And his mother cried as he walked out, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." He laughed and kissed his mom and said, "You're Billy Joe's a man. I can shoot as quick and straight as anybody can. But I wouldn't shoot without a cause. I'd gun nobody down." But she cried again as he rode away, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." He sang a song as on he rode, his guns hung at his hips. He rode into a cattle town, a smile upon his lips. He stopped and walked into a bar and laid his money down. But his mother's words echoed again, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." He drank his first strong liquor then to calm his shaking hand, and tried to tell himself at last he had become a man. A dusty cowpoke at his side began to laugh him down. And he heard again his mother's words, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town." Filled with rage, then Billy Joe reached for his gun to draw. But the stranger drew his gun and fired before he even saw. As Billy Joe fell to the floor, the crowd all gathered round and wondered at his final words, "Don't take your guns to town, son. Leave your guns at home, Bill. Don't take your guns to town."
Out in the West Texas town of El Paso, I fell in love with a Mexican girl. Nighttime would find me in Rose's Cantina. Music would play and Felina would whirl. Blacker than night were the eyes of Felina, wicked and evil while casting a spell. My love was deep for this Mexican maiden. I was in love, but in vain I could tell. One night a wild young cowboy came in, wild as the West Texas wind. Dashing and daring, a drink he was sharing with wicked Felina, the girl that I love. So in anger I challenged his right for the love of this maiden. Down put his hand for the gun that he wore. My challenge was answered in less than a heartbeat. The handsome young stranger lay dead on the floor. Out through the back door of Roses I ran, out where the horses were tied. I caught a good one, it looked like it could run. A
up on its back and away I did ride, just as fast as I could, from the West Texas town of El Paso back to the badlands of New Mexico. Back in El Paso, my life would be worthless. Everything's gone in life, nothing is left. It's been so long since I've seen the young maiden. My love is stronger than my fear of death. I saddled up and away I did go, riding alone in the dark. Maybe tomorrow a bullet may find me. Tonight nothing's worse than this pain in my heart. And at last here I am on the hill overlooking El Paso. I can see Rose's cantina below. My love is strong and it pushes me onward. Down off the hill to Felina I go. Off to my right I see five mounted cowboys, off to my left right a dozen or more. Shouting and shooting, I can't let them catch me. I have to make it to Rose's back door. Something is dreadfully wrong, for I feel a deep burning pain in my side. Though I am trying to stay in the saddle, I'm getting weary, unable to ride. But my love for Felina is strong, and I rise where I've fallen. Though I am weary, I can't stop to rest. I see the white puff of smoke from the rifle. I feel the bullet go deep in my chest. From out of nowhere, Felina has found me, kissing my cheek as she kneels by my side. Cradled by two loving arms that I'll die for. One little kiss and Felina goodbye.
It's that time again to say adios. And we close with two songs where soldiers shoot the fatal shots. One fictional, one fact. One song where our hero is shot by the enemy, and one where protesting students are incredibly and implausibly shot and killed by so-called friendly fire. It's the true account of the Kent State killings in Ohio in 1970 by Crosby, Stills, Nash & Young. I myself was a college student completing my senior year when this happened. Many colleges shut down that spring of 1970. Mine was included. It was a harrowing time in the United States. That first song was a number one pop hit from 1974 called Billy, Don't Be a Hero, as the girl at home implores. Billy didn't listen. Thanks for listening till the end. This is Thematic Nostalgia, show number 65. I was your host, and my name is Phil.
Make me your wife. sergeant cried, "We've got to hang on, boys. We got to hold this piece of ground. I need a volunteer to ride up and bring us back some extra men." And Billy's hand was up in a moment, forgetting all the words she said. Billy died that day. The letter said that he was a hero. She should be proud he died that way. I heard she threw the letter away.
Bye. swear that I'm sincere. I'd give the world and all I own if I could keep you here. And have I never told you? Can you please believe my claim? That through it all I've loved you just the same.